ഒരു വിഷയം പഠിക്കാം പക്ഷേ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് അനുഭവമാക്കണമെന്ന് നിർബന്ധം
You can go to a college and learn a subject, but it is not mandatory that you do
this.
But what if God is not in that way? If you learn it, you have to abide to it. God is not considering the time that you did not know about it. But God will ask you for the things that you have known in your life. Once again, our earnest prayer to God should be what we are learning from the Word of God and we have to experience in our
life.
We have learned about Psalm 4 many times. And the one lesson that we have to learn that I will peacefully sleep. And the peace of God is one thing that a child of God experiences in his life. The grain and wine increase will not help us. It's only God who can give you the peace. The person who wrote this psalm was a king. Despite his wealth and luxury, he says, even though my grain and wine increased, nothing can help me but it's God's peace. The second is something that we need to be fearful. And we should not sin is the second part. There are times that we can sin in this world, but not to sin is our responsibility. And when we are fearful in the presence of God, we will not relent to any kind of sin. Last night we learned because of one man's disobedience, the entire world was cursed. God did not provide the angels that Cain will not sin. God is telling to Cain that the sin's desire is towards you. You have to rule over it. God is not giving some provisions that you can rule over it, but God has already given it to us that we can rule over the sin. But today God has not appointed that
message.
And the third thing that we have to know is in the midst of it. Remember that the saint of God is given out to God as well. The children of God, you should know that there is a group of people that is separated for God. Everything was created by God. And everything was created in this world according for the image of God and for man. Everything that we see in our surroundings is for us. But not for other things in this world or the creation of man. Everything was created for mankind. We were made only for God. But God is not receiving every man for him. Only one separated group belongs to God. And they are being called the saints of God. They are not called as wise people. They are not called wealthy people. They are not called beautiful people. There are people who may accept knowledge. Knowledge is a great and blessed experience. Only when you are close to a person, there will be a feeling whether you should love them
or not.
We can only decide when we are close to a people if we can trust them or not. We need a knowledge.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's desire for mankind is man should know who God is. Job was a
faithful.
There were many things that God could tell about Job. But he did not know God the way it needs to be. So that God may know him, God put into the depths of the same. Everything that was for him, God plucked apart. Whatever could be done to his body, God did it. At the end is saying, I have only heard something about
you.
But now I know who my God is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God's desire is we should know God the way it should be. Why is God doing in that manner? If we know God to the full extent, nobody can stop us from following our discipleship. There is a different part to it. This is how God taught Daniel. And those who know God will stand and do valiantly. And when there are sinful acts that you do not stand towards it, if you need to stand still, you should know who God is. Those who know God is a blessed man. God expecting from us that we should know who He is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Any saint who has been blessed knew who God is. And who the person is going against, knowledge, know who God is. Last week we learned about Abraham. And looking at Abraham when he is old. When God is looking at Abraham, he doesn't even have
a presence.
And in his stomach or in the serous, he's seeing the nations. He's seeing the kings.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. A man who doesn't even have 1 cent to claim to himself in
Mamre.
A man who left everything because God asked him to. In the world there is nothing for him. He's old now. When the world looks, he needs to die. When God looks at him, when God is looking at him, he's been a man who should die. A man who has nothing. A man who is
complaining.
God is looking at nobles. God is seeing the king. God is
seeing
the miser. God is seeing many nations. This morning, that's what God is looking at you. What you are not looking, God is looking inside you. Look at you, there's nothing. like the stars in the sky.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If you accept and take the word of God, God will enable in your lives as well. You all desire to come here this morning only because God wants you here this morning. A small accident could have prevented you from coming. If you are here, that is true, then God has something to do for you. Let God see something in your soul. What God saw in Abraham is what we learned last week. Today we are going to learn what we have, what Abraham saw in God. This morning may we receive many blessings from God. What did Abraham see in God? And when Stephen was preaching, he said that he saw the glory of God. And when the 7th chapter of Acts of Apostles starts, we read it this way, that he saw the glory of God. Hallelujah. Who is our God?
Compare anything in comparison to it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You should see who your God is. Not only to hear who God is, you need to see who your God is. You have to look at him and be radiant. Those who see God will see the world as small.
Hallelujah.
Abraham saw the glory of his God.
Hallelujah.
It did not end there.
Abraham
is continuing his journey. Once he had to beat a war, he had to go and save his brother Lot out of the enemy. In Genesis 34, we can read it. And then he was coming back after defeating the strong kings. The Sodom king came and told him in this way: you give me your man and take all the wealth of Sodom. There is one thing that Abraham said: I am raising my hands to Almighty God and saying this. I don't even need a shoe, and what are you going to give me? So that nobody will say that you made me rich. I'm throwing away everything you give me. Abraham, what do you throw
in?
I'm seeing my God again. Genesis
14:22-23.
God most high, the possessor of heaven and earth. Which means that Sodom came, you can only give what God has given. Do you know what God is going to give me? The possessor of heaven and earth. Do you need the possessor of heaven and earth, or do you need for Sodom only? Even though the entire kings of the world give you everything, they can give what is the world. But my God is not only the God of the earth, He is also the authority over the heavens. Only that God can give what is there. At that time, Abraham raised his hands to heaven. Which means that what God is giving me, that is enough. Let your vision be expanded this morning.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
America can't hide it.
കാര്യം.
Everything will be born in the
soul. ആകാശം കൂടി മുഴുക്കത്തോടെ ഒഴിഞ്ഞു പോകും.
And the heaven with a great
sound. ഭൂമി മുതൽ പണികളും നടന്നുരുന്നു.
Again, Abraham is seeing
God.
That's why by the grace of God, we named our church. God, Judge El Shaddai, that's what been said there. And God is appearing to him. And God is saying who he is. I am El Shaddai, I am the Almighty God.
Hallelujah.
Each and every word has a great depth into it.
He
said, I am El Shaddai. And Abraham is seeing God. Not only is the glorious God,
he
is not only the possessor
of
God, he is an Almighty God. So that I may bring a covenant. So that with your children, people are staying with your covenant.
അബ്രഹാമിന് 99 വയസ്സായപ്പോൾ യഹോവ അബ്രഹാമിന് പ്രത്യക്ഷനായി അവനോട് ഞാൻ സർവശക്തിയുള്ള ദൈവമാകുന്നു. നീ എന്റെ മുമ്പാകെ നടന്ന് നിഷ്കളങ്കനായിരിക്ക. എനിക്കും നിനക്കും മധ്യേ ഞാൻ എന്റെ നിയമം സ്ഥാപിക്കും.
കണ്ടോ, ദൈവം ഒരു നിയമം സ്ഥാപിക്കാനാണ് വന്നത്. ഈ താഴെയിട്ട് വായിച്ച് അതിന് 10 വാചകം.
എനിക്കും നിങ്ങൾക്കും നിന്റെ ശേഷം നിന്റെ സന്തതിക്കും മധ്യയുള്ളതും നിങ്ങൾ പ്രമാണിക്കേണ്ടതുമായ എന്റെ നിയമാവിത നിങ്ങളിൽ പുരുഷ പ്രജയൊക്കെയും പരിച്ഛേദനയാക്കണം.
മതി, ശ്രദ്ധിച്ചേ, ഇനി കൂടെ ശ്രദ്ധിക്കേ. ദൈവം എന്തിനാ വന്നേ?
Why did God come?
സർവശക്തിയുള്ള യഹോവ എന്തിനാ വന്നേ?
Why did Almighty God come?
അവനും അവന്റെ കുടുംബത്തിൽ പറന്നവർക്കും കുടുംബത്തിൽ ജീവിക്കുന്നവർക്കും ഒരു നിയമം കൊടുക്കാൻ.
To give a covenant to his family.
ആ നിയമം എന്താണെന്നറിയോ?
Do you know what the covenant is?
ഒരു വേലസോട് നടക്കാനല്ല.
Not to go with the Bible.
10 ദൈവത്തിന് കൊടുക്കാനല്ല.
Not to delay $10.
ഒരാളും പോയി ദൈവത്തെ കുറിച്ച് പറവാനല്ല.
Not to speak about God.
വേദന എടുക്കാൻ.
To take a pain.
Praise the Lord. നിന്റെ വീട്ടിൽ ജനിച്ചതിനെല്ലാം നിനക്കും വേദന തരാൻ.
to give pain to you and everything body.
சோர வெளியில் வரத்தக்க வண்ணம் முறிக்க.
So that blood may come out.
பரிசேதனை ஏற்க.
To circumcise.
கண்டோ சகோதரர்களே. தெய்வத்தின் பிரமாணம் அனுசரித்து நிஷ்கலங்கனாகணுமெங்கில் பிரமாணம் அனுசரிப்பார் நீ முதல் முடக்கணும்.
You have to pay a price if God's covenant need to be with you.
நமக்கு தோதுகா எழுப்பமானோ.
We may think it is an easy task.
எழுப்பமல்ல தெய்வத்தை அனுசரிக்க.
It is not easy to obey God.
அனுசரிக்கான் புத்திமுட்டா.
It is very hard to obey the scripture.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
இது அனுசரிக்கான் புத்திமுட்டா.
It is hard to explain.
அனுசரிச்சாலே நீ நிஷ்கலங்கனாய் இருக்கதுள்ளு.
Only if you obey, you will be fearful.
பிரமாணமாய் இறங்கி வந்த தெய்வத்தின் பரியாய பதம் கேட்போம்.
Do you see the second name of God who came there?
Almighty God.
He is an almighty God.
Sarvashaktanaya Deivam.
God who is almighty.
Avada nee nishkalankanaay nilkanam.
Over there you need to be very humble.
Nilkanamengil vedana eduthalum avante pramanam anusarikkanam.
Even though you are in pain, yeah, you have to obey his covenant.
Abraham parayunnu Deivame nan pramanam okke anusarikkan matte vashamam ullathonnu parayunnathu.
If Abraham would have said that, Lord, I'm ready to listen to everything but no pain.
Nee vedana eduthe nan Deivame anusarikkanam.
You have to take the pain and obey. If they did something this way, they have to get a reward. And then they will become like an animal. What they do, they get a reference
to that.
So to do a bad work, they will stop themselves. And for a Muslim, the teaching is what they do in this world, they will get over here.
அவரே நான் வந்து ஏதோ அதனுசரிச்சு அவரோட சிச்ச நாக்கு முறுக்கி கை முறுக்கி கழுத்து முறுக்கி ஒக்கி
ஐ டு ஐ ஹேட் டு ஹேண்ட் ஹியர் டு ஹியர் எவ்ரிதிங் வில் பீ கட்
கிறிஸ்டியானிக்கு அறியணும்
யூ நோ வாட் அபௌட் கிறிஸ்டியன்ஸ்
ஆர் எல்லாரும் உமதாரிச்சு அவங்க அதை மாறிக்கிட்டு
ஃபார் எ கிறிஸ்டியன் யூ ஜஸ்ட் repent yourself in front of the
priest.
It's such an easy thing.
ஏது குண்டகேடு கண்டது அப்படி 20 க்கு பைசா கொடுத்தா எது கும்பிட்டு காரியம் பண்ணு சூசூசூ சங்கதி மாறி.
So you just do any bad thing, you just need to go and tell the church priest everything.
நடக்கதில்ல சகோதரர்களே.
It will not be done.
நம்மட பிரமாணமா சக்தி உள்ள பிரமாணம்.
Our promise and the covenant is the strong one.
அவரவன் சரித்துக்கு மாட்டேயோ நல்லவாகும் தீவால் அந்த தக்கவண்ணோ.
When you are in this body, then do not marry it in reference and good to that.
இது அத்தனமும் கும்பிட்டு கும்பு சாலித்து காரியம் சாதிப்பிக்காமல் பிரமாணம் வந்தா.
We are not getting a law that we can go to a church priest and say it.
சர்வசக்தி உள்ள தெய்வத்தின் முன்பாக நிஷ்கலங்கனாய் நிற்கிற பிரமாணமானது.
It is a law that you have to stand in front of the Almighty God.
Hallelujah.
அவரே ஒத்தி படிப்பிக்கின்றதா പക്ഷേ സമയത്തിന്റെ പരിമിതി നാം മുന്നോട്ട് വേഗം ഓടുക.
Hallelujah.
എന്നെ മനസ്സിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവന്നേ ദൈവം തേജോമയനാണ്.
Bring to your mind, God is glorious.
ദൈവം അത്യുന്നതനാണ്.
God is possessor.
ദൈവം യേശുവായി സർവശക്തൻ.
God is El Shaddai, the Almighty God.
ഈ മൂന്ന് കാര്യത്തിലും അബ്രഹാമിനുണ്ടായി ചേഞ്ച് ദൈവങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കി.
You understand in all these three instances the change that happened.
തന്റെ ദേശത്തേക്കാൾ സ്വർഗ്ഗത്തെ വലുതായി കണ്ടു.
More than his place he considered
സ്വർഗ്ഗത്തിന്റെ സമ്പത്തിനേക്കാൾ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ സമ്പത്ത് വലുതായി കണ്ടു.
More than the sovereign's wealth he considered God's wealth.
സർവശക്തന്റെ മുമ്പിൽ വേദനപ്പെട്ടാണെങ്കിലും അവൻ തന്ന പ്രമാണം അനുസരിക്കുന്നതിന്റെ പദവി കണ്ടു.
And more than the pain he saw the abiding and obedience of the covenant of God.
ലോകത്തിൽ പരിചയത്തിൽ ഏറ്റയാ ഒരു വർഗ്ഗത്തിലുള്ള വ്യത്യാസം ദൈവങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കിക്കൊണ്ടു.
You have to understand that is the only people who were circumcised during that time.
അത് ശാസ്ത്രീയമായും ഭൗതികമായും ആത്മീയമായും ഒരു വലിയ വില ആ വർഗ്ഗത്തിന് കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട്.
And a great price has been paid by that group even scientifically, spiritually and
ലോകത്തിന്റെ മധ്യഭാഗത്തവർ ദൈവത്തിനായി നിൽക്കുന്നവരാണ്.
In the center part of the world, that group is standing for God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
ഒത്തിരി നമുക്ക് ഇവിടെ പഠിപ്പാനായിട്ടുണ്ട്.
We can learn many things from here.
നീ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ പ്രമാണത്തിൽ നിൽക്കുമ്പോൾ നീ സാധാരണക്കാരനല്ല.
If you stand in the law of God, you're not an ordinary person.
ആര് പ്രമാണമാണ് അനുസരിക്കുന്നത് കേട്ടോ? സർവ്വശക്തന്റെ പ്രമാണമാണ്.
You're abiding and obeying duplicate the Bible.
യേശുവിന്റെ കാലത്ത് അവർ വേദപുസ്തകം പഠിപ്പിക്കുന്നവരായിരുന്നു.
And during the time of Jesus, they taught the Bible.
അന്ന് നല്ലൊരു വേദപാഠശാല ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു ഗമാലിയേലിന്റെ പാഠശാല യെരുശലേമിൽ.
A good school of theology of type of God there is in Gamaliel.
അറിയപ്പെടുന്ന വേദപാഠശാലയായിരുന്നു അത്.
And it was the world renowned place to learn.
അതിന്റെ ഡിഗ്രി എന്ന വ്യക്തിയായിരുന്നു ശൌല അഥവാ പൗലോസ്.
And Saul was there called Paul also took a degree from there.
അവിടുന്ന് പഠിച്ചതോടെ പഠിപ്പിക്കുന്നവർ
And lot of people teaching and talking over there. But where they were teaching and doing everything, there were demons. But when Jesus went to that place, when he preached, the demons went away. When he preached, the demons went away. When a person learns and obeys the word of God, he is a mighty person.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you the fourth thing and end today.
You
come chapter 21.
You're
coming to the message. God is going to give you the message. Till now you were just learning. But now God is going to touch you. Everybody pray. To know you only God and you can know this morning. I don't know what it is. But the God who we serve knows about it. God of Abraham knows it. No matter the great problem, God knows it. And beyond above everything, believe. Hallelujah. The Satan cannot come alone on the fire. But to bring him outside, God is possible. Cannot have the ability to come out of the
dead.
God has the ability to bring him outside.
He
has not the ability to come out of prison. There was something hassle with the king of that place. After that, it was resolved. And Abraham was sitting under a tree. He resolved a problem with one of the mighty king at that time. After that, Abraham was sitting under a tree. Last two words of chapter 21.
Abraham Beersheba-il oru pishila vrusham nattu. Nithya deivam മായ യഹോവയുടെ നാമത്തിൽ അവിടെ വെച്ച് ആരാധന കഴിച്ചു.
കണ്ടോ അബ്രഹാം ദൈവത്തെ കണ്ടത് എങ്ങനെയാണ്?
How did Abraham see God?
Nithyanaya Devam.
It's an everlasting God.
Abraham, ini enna endu cheythu?
Abraham, what did you do after that?
Naan enna Devathe aaradhichu.
I worshiped Allah.
Hallelujah.
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 Abraham, Devathe kanda vazhigalaanu naam kadannu vannathu.
And what, how Abraham saw God, that's what we learned.
Ini avan oru minute munpottu kaal veppan kadiyathilla.
He cannot step further apart.
Devathinte munpil veenu kadakkunna manushya.
A man who is bowed down in front of God.
Aadim deshathe vittavana naam kandu.
First we saw a person who left his place.
And
this time he saw the glory of God. Second he saw who rejected Sodom.
And
he saw the possessor God. The third is he took that pain.
And
he saw the Almighty God. But now he's laid down. He's laid down.
Abraham,
lay down. Abraham, who is your God now? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, children of God. Be in the presence of God. And you have to bow in the Your God. And when you are preparing yourself for the sacrifice, your God is considering and providing you there another end. How long is God and people live?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. A lot of wild animals. And if a ram is running over there, they will come behind and kill it. And this ram is completely in the
thicket.
It cannot run them.
മുഖം
And they are completely covering their face when they knew that God is holy. And the Sarah see that they have hidden their faces with their
Every room of your house should be a worship place.
People who work in the kitchen, rejoice in God and do your work.